Good afternoon, students. So yesterday we discussed about the binary search algorithm.
Okay.
We also discussed quick sort, match sort by using divide and conquer technique. Next we solve the binary search algorithm. Okay, and we also discussed about a max number and minimum number in the given array. Okay. So this is the algorithm we discussed in the yesterday class. By using this mid value, divide the algorithm into two subparts. Now the complexity is big O of n. Okay. Anybody has any doubt, please write a message. Any doubts in the match sort or quick sort or binary search algorithm, any analysis if you want to, any about how to analyze quick sort or any doubt regarding quick sort, match sort, binary search or find the min and max values of the given array using divide and conquer approach. Any queries, please write a message in chat box. Okay. So today we discussed the last but one topic in second unit, that is performance measurement. The last topic is randomizer algorithm, the last topic in the second unit. We will discuss this randomized algorithm today also after completing the performance measurement. So coming to the performance measurement, actually the performance will be concerned with the how much time will require and how much space is required for the particular algorithm we call as the performance measurement. So here this performance measurement depends on the compiler and also which algorithm we are used to execute. So depending upon the which type of compiler we use and what are which algorithm we use for to complete that problem, it will depending upon these quantities. Okay, so here in this we just already discussed about how to calculate space and how to calculate time complexity. Just in this lecture we see only the time needed for compilation. Okay, so why we are not considered the space means, see here in this each program is compiled and executed, each program is compiled once and executed several times. So for that purpose we have to calculate the time measurement of the just concentrate on the time. Okay, we already discussed analysis in the previous lectures, and now we discussed the time, how much time it required for the completion of the algorithm. Okay, we are taking time means here every program is compiled once and but executed several times. So we calculated now on the time, what is the time required for this algorithm. Okay, so before this we discuss the performance. So coming to the performance measurement, so here in this we do not consider the measuring the running time, measuring the runtime space requirements of the program. We do not consider the runtime space requirements of the program. Rather we focus on measuring the computing time of the program. Oh, just to we do not consider the space requirement of the program, but here we consider only the measuring the computing time of a program. So to obtain the computing or runtime of a program, we need a clock procedure here. Okay, so we need a clock procedure. So also here we need to do is making use of clocking of procedure. Here I am using one clocking procedure, that is nothing but the get time. I'm using the one clocking procedure that is called as get time. By using this clocking procedure, I can measure the time of that program. So actually get time means it gets the real time value of the system. Okay, so it gets the real time value of a system. So so see here in this for calculating the measuring time, so by using this procedure, so here get time means get time that returns the current time in milliseconds. Okay, so it is the real time, the time value of the system. So we consider this clocking procedure is nothing but the get time. How we calculate, we see in the next slides. So for this algorithm, for calculating the clocking procedure, we are using for calculating our performance in performance measurement about time. So we consider the sequential set. So what is, first of all, we must know what is a sequential set. So all of you know about linear set or sequential set. In this, the data elements will be searched in linear order. The element is present or not, it will search by in linear order. So consider this example. See here, this is my data. Okay, I'm giving 10, 20, 30, 15, 11. Okay, so in this sequence sets or linear sets were performed on both sorted and unsorted data. But coming to the binary search, it will perform searching on only sorted data. Coming to linear search, it will perform both on sorted and unsorted data. Now I want to search the element 15 in the given array. Okay, so it will search the element with 10. So if it is not matched, then it move, then it will consider with A of one element. It will also not match, then sequentially it will search the second index data, and then it will search the third index data, then it will find. So in this way, linearly it will search the data in the given array. So so in this in linear search, if the element the best case is, if the element is the starting element in the array, it is the best case for linear search. Okay, so what is the worst case in the linear search means, if the data is not present in the list, or the data in the last element is the searching data, it is also the worst case of this algorithm. Okay, so see here, worst case performance is the element is not in the list, or the element, the last element in the list is the searching element. So these two cases comes under the worst case performance of the sequential set. So if the I want to search the element 11, so the data will search the entire array search the entire array till end, because the element will find on the last one. So that is the worst case of sequential set. So the worst case performance sequence set, so is, I already told you, the first, the element is not in the list, or the last element of the list, we call it as a worst case. So before we can do this, we need to know, we need to decide value of n for which times are to be obtained. Okay, so decide the value of n here, for which times it is to be obtained, and also determine for each of the value of n, the data exit is the worst behavior. So here in this example, already I want to set the element 11. So n value is 4. So each time you have to check the n value for that searching element. Okay. So here decide the decide on the value of n. So my n value is 4, and determine for each value of n. So for n value of 0 index, the searching element is 11. That is not matched. Then it move to the n value 1. 20 is compare not matched in the twice sequentially compare. So for this purpose, I write here one algorithm. Okay, I write here one algorithm for sequential set. See here, this is the algorithm. Okay, so far clear or any doubt, please write a message. So algorithm for sequential set, A is my array, X is my key, means that is which element I want to set that is stored in N, that is KIX. Here, N is the size of the array. Means how much elements you have to set, that is the size of the array. Here is A is array and N is the size. Okay. So search for X. X is my searching element from 1 to N. Okay. So N is the last element, means the size of the array starts from A of 1. Okay, I am searching the element from A of 1. Actually, array elements, array index starts from 0 to starts index 0 to and so on, 0 to N. But I am searching the element from 1 to N. See here, A of 0 is additional space, is nothing but I just store the X, means searching element in the array. For example, I want to set the element to 0. Okay, I want to set the element is 0. Okay, so that element is stored in A of 0. Okay, so I am using this as for just store the searching element in A of 0. Remaining, I compare remaining data will start from 1 to N. I start array index from 1 to N. Okay, so see here I take any I equal to N, A of 0 equal to X. Okay. So I just compare this algorithm starts from N to 0. Okay, starts from N to low, starts from high element to the low element. So I'm taking I as N, the last element in the array. Okay, so if while A of I not equal to X, so if the element not equal to X, so first element is now, for example, this element is 10, nth element is 10, 10 is not equal to S, decrement I by 1, then we search for N minus 1, then you move for N minus 2. Okay, I just write the algorithm in reverse order. If you want to write the algorithm from starting onwards, you just give A of I equal to 1 and compare until the condition false. Okay, I'm just consider this example in reverse order. So far clear or any doubt? Okay, I just take this in reverse order. So A is the array and X is the searching element. N is the size of the array here. Size of the array size. Okay. Or we can search the different size of the array representing as a N is the different size of the array. Okay, so here only we search only in this algorithm. We just for this purpose we are taking here N, just the size of the array here. Okay, so Now see this algorithm. In this, so the decision on which value of n to use is based on the amount of timing. So we wish to perform, and also on what we expect to do with the times once they are obtained. Okay. So assume that for a linear search, our intention is simply to predict how long it will take in the worst case. So to search for x given the size n of a. Okay, to search for x we given the size n of a. So for asymptotic notations you already studied. So the time complexity for this is theta of n. For best worst case, the time complexity is theta of n. So we accept a plot of the time to be a straight line. Okay, so for this, just we see here. So if you know the times for any two values of n, the straight line is determined, and we can obtain the time for all other values of n from this timeline. For example, if you are linear search means this is the time and this is the n value. The data will be considered for between two points. That the graph will flow light in linear way. Because it is linear set, it will find first element, then if it can second one linearly, it will move. For in practice, we need the times for more than two values. So in this, we set the algorithm for more than two values of n. So why we set for more than two values? The reason is, see here, for asymptotic analysis, tell us the behavior only for sufficiently large values of n. So we use the asymptotic analysis for the large values, and for smaller values of n, the runtime may not follow the asymptotic curve. So if the n value is small, it will not follow this type of curve. So to determine the point beyond the asymptotic curve, so we need to examine the time for several values of n. So for better understanding, okay, so better understanding, see here. So I am taking some function f of n equal to 5n. Okay, if the function is like this, the graph has constantly move in linear order. If the function some extra two values are there, another value is there, that's why I'm taking more than two values. The function has this type of value compared to n, the log n value is higher. So whenever the highest value is when the log n value will change, so the graph will not come this may be graph in parabola maybe, or it may be in hyperbola. Okay, so it may be hyperbola, it may be in parabola shape, because the here we have the n value, consider here log n. And but depending on the log n, whenever the n value increases, the graph will not move in straight in linear way. It will move either hyperbolic or parabolic. Okay, so that is the problem for the problem. We have to take more than two values of n. Is it clear? For smaller value, the runtime may not follow asymptotic curve. Okay, that's why we are taking more than two values of n. So even in the region where the asymptotic behavior is exhibited, the times may not lie exactly on the predicted curve. That is, see here, straight line in linear search, it is in straight line. Okay, so for linear search, it may be it is in straight line. because of the effects of low order terms that are disabled in the asymptotic notations. See one example, that is C1 into N plus C plus C2 star into log N plus C3. So for that matter, any other functions of N is which then the highest order term C1 star N for some constant C1 greater than 0. So in this case, we have the function is C2 log N function. Whenever the N value is high, for comparing this linear search, the graph will converted in either hyperbolic or parabolic, not is in a straight line. Okay, so that is the reason we consider more than, for practice, we need the times for more than two values of N. Clear or any doubt? Clear or any doubt? Please write a message. Is it clear? Next time move to the example. So we have to see the table here for N different values. So N, for N contains here 0 and N contains 10 elements, N contains 20 elements for different values of N. We are writing this linear search algorithm. Okay. Okay, for different types of N, we are considering this linear search algorithm. I am taking this N values is different from 0 to 1000. One time the N value is 0 and one time the N is 10. So different values of N I am taking here. That is, see the example here, algorithm time search. See the example clearly. Okay, algorithm for time set, I am taking J equal to 1 to 1000. Do. Okay, so I am taking the values from 1 to 1000. Do A of J equal to J here. So I am taking J value from 1, 2, 3 and so on. 1000. Okay, so initially J value is 1, so A of J is 1. Okay, so initial J value is zero means A of 1. If J equal to 1, this is the array size I am taking 1 to 1000. J value is 1, A of 1, we can store the element in, we can compare the element with the A of 1 element. Okay, just see later, just see this is the starting from 1 to 1000 values, I am taking array 1 to 1000. Next move, next is for I equal to 1 to 10. Okay, so I am taking these 10 elements and these 10 elements. So I am taking 1 to 10, only these two are 10. So 1 to 10 elements I am taking. Okay, do then N of J equal to, see here, N and J here. So see here, first just come here. First come here, then we move to the searching element. So this is the sequential shift. A is the array. G, 0 is my searching element. In previous, I am taking X. Now in this, I am took as X, 0. I want to search element is 0. Then NJ. Okay. So here N is for different sizes of the array. So here N value, array size is 0 here, and array size 10 here, array size 20, array size 30, array size 40, array size 900, array size 1000. So I am taking 1 to 1000 for I am taking array N size with different. So that's why I am taking here N of J. Okay, clear. So N of J is nothing but different sizes of array or array of problem of difference, different array of different problems we are taken here. Understand? A is my array and N is the different sizes of array. just move so inside first n of j initially. First, what is the n of j here? First, consider this example for 10 into n of j equal to 10 into j minus 1. So, j value is 1 here, initially 1, 1 minus 1, 0. So, 10 into 0. So, see here a. So, what is the n value here and what is the n value here? So, we are taking two n values from 1 to 10. This is one value from 1 to 10. This is another value from starts from 100 to 1000. Here starts from 0 to 10. See here for 10. For index is 1. So for index 1, the data Okay, due to some problem, so Srishti may be starting. So just continue the session. All of you stay online 1 minute and just share the PPT once again. Okay, so coming to okay, so coming to this searching technique, see here. So see here, I am taken here in this. Just to see the example here. So here n values differ from 0 to 100. So initially at index 1, n is at size 0. And here where index j equal to 1. So j equal to 1 is here, j equal to 1, 1 plus 1, 11. At n value, at 11 index, that is 100. See, size is 100. Okay. And n value is 2, index is 2, this is 10, and index 12, this is 200. Similarly, up to up to 9, the n value n is 9, and up to 20, the n is 1000. At 20th tick says n is 1000. At 9 index, n is 90. Okay, clear. So in this way, we are repeating this loop. Okay, so in this way, you have to repeat the elements, this table. We are creating this table in this taking by for loop. N of j equal to 10 into j minus 1 and n of j plus 1 equal to. Okay, now I am considering the n of different sizes. So that's why I'm taking j equal to 1 to 20, because this element, this table contains n as 20 elements. So I'm taking loop from 1 to 20. Here I am using this clocking procedure function get time. I already told it get the real time value of the system. Get time means it get the real time value of the system. Okay, clear. It get the real time value of the system. Now here I am getting sequence of sets of 0, A of 0 and 1 to array is A, and the searching element is 0. And this is the different sizes of n we are taking, n of j. So in first time, get the time for I equal to 1, for I equal to 1 index. Get the time, it will get the time. So here h is the starting time of the time measuring, starting time, and the H1 is the end time. In between, you have to perform sequential search. So we have to first get the start time of the searching search, and here after search, what is the end time of the search. So here H is the starting time of the search, and H1 is the end time. So whenever the J equal to 1, the start time will start here. Then search. So A value at index 1, the array 0, the searching element is 0. Then it will match. Then it will return the value. Okay, it will return 0. So in previous algorithms here, whenever the search is found, return I. So return the value 0. Okay. And it will end the time. Then it will search another element that I equal to 2, 2 equal to starts 10. Then it will search. In this way, the process is continuous. First search is 0. Next, we have to search for 10 elements. Then we have to search for 20 elements. We have to search for 30 and so on. Up to 1000, you have to search the element. Okay. Then you have to calculate the time required for the, how much time required to get to search the element is H1 minus H. That is end time minus starting time. Okay. So this will represented as N of J comma T. T equal to total time it will take. Okay. So just see here in this table, after writing this program, this is the output for this program. See here, for n equal to 0, this time we considered in milliseconds. This is 0 for n 10 also, 0, 0. For see here, in this 300, it will getting time is 1 microsecond. For 300, it will take 1 microsecond. For 400, it consider it will get only 0 microsecond. For 500, n value is 500, it get 1 microsecond. So here we are not getting the proper values. So actually what I am expected means here we are getting, whenever the n value increases, the time will also increases here. Whenever the n value increases, the time for taking, the time taking for search also increases. But here in this algorithm, we are getting the constant time in this manner. That is, here most of the time is 0. So here the t value increases, time value is constant position. So time value may not be occur due to the value of n is small. So for n value small, so here the constant value is occur. But our expected value is like this. In this way we are expecting, but here the values are represented in this way. So here 0, 0, 0 is a constant. Okay. So our expected output is here, but here this is the actual output, but we are expected output is in this way. So here the total time is not in correct way. So see here to time a short event, it is necessary to repeat it several times. So this is not the correct output. So we have to repeat it several times and divide the total time and total time for event by number of repetitions. So to get the correct value, we have to repeat the input several times and divide the total time for the number of repetitions. Okay. So this so to solve this, I just change the algorithm is same. It is just I am introduce two here. Just see the algorithm. Okay, see here, this is the algorithm. Just I just same algorithm, just introduce two things. One is R, that is reputation factor, and I take here one loop here. In previous we are not taking any loops. Here I am considering same algorithm. Just I took one for loop here and also one repeating factors here. See here, in this initially for loop, actually same program, but here, see here, I am taking for I equal to 1 to R of j. So R of j means how many times I repeat that set thing. So initially, I start with 0. 0 times I am repeating. Then I repeat this searching with 2 lakhs. Again, in the next time, we again repeat the algorithm at 2 lakhs times, and I am repeating this algorithm 1 lakh 50 times, and I am repeating the algorithm 1 lakh. In middle, I am repeating this algorithm 50,000. In some middle, some time, I am repeating this algorithm 25 times. Because if you are not getting the proper values by giving the see here in this, we are not getting the proper values because the repeating n value is small. So that's why we repeat this in several times to get the good result. Okay, so for that purpose, I am taking this algorithm with repeating factors R, that is R of j. J is 0, it will repeat 0 times, j 2 lakh times, the set process will continue. Okay, clear? So just this is the algorithm for the process. Similarly, just check the conditions. Initially, n at index 1 is 0, and at index 1 is, at index 11, it is 100. At index 2, this is 10. At index 12, this is 200, and so on. At index 9, it is 90. At index 20, this is the same process will continue. Okay, but the number of searching time is increases here. For one n value is 0, just it will repeat that at 0 times. When n value is 1, it will increment RJ value is 2. So it will repeat the process 2 lakh times. So the process will repeat 2 lakh times. So here G is the get time, starting time, and ending time. So T1 equal to H1 minus, it means the total time required. And T is the, for one set, how much time will require? For one iteration, how much time will require? That we calculated by T by R of J. R of J is the reputation factor value. For example, see here, this is the table after milliseconds. For example, this is the at T1 iteration, total time is 308 milliseconds. For each iteration, it will take 0.002. So how will you calculate means here 308 in milliseconds, that is 10 power minus 3 by 2 lakh. So we get for each iteration, we get the 0.002 value here. So for each iteration, we will get here. So in this way, see here in this, for n value is 0, that is time is different here, 308 for n value 10. So here the time, whenever the n value increases, the time is increasing here. So in this way, we do the measure the time. So this is the correct procedure. So we are random, we are taking here n value for time for repeating the factors, then we get the correct value. In previous algorithm, we cannot repeat the algorithm. So here we are repeating the algorithm for number of times. So we are getting the correct value. See, this is the improper timing constant, because every time we get the time and set the element, we end the time. We start the time, end the time. And starting for every setting, for example, for first iteration, you start, you get the first starting time and the searching element found or not found and the ending time. So this is not the proper way, and we calculate this is the end of the loop. So this is the improper timing constraint. So for this type of algorithm, we cannot get the correct timing chart, correct timing measure. So this is about the performance measurement. Okay. So today we end the session. Tomorrow we will discuss about randomized algorithm. That is the last topic in second unit. Any queries, please write a message. Okay. Today end the session. Thank you.